Hey, what's up guys, it's Markey here. I thought I would show you guys some of the kits I've made on PES 2013. As you know, Konami do not have the licenses for the kits in the Premier League other than Manchester United, so you have to make do with the crappy ones they have. So I decided to make a few of them myself. Obviously you are limited to what you can do with 4 slots, and if you want the actual badges you have to make the badges yourself. I haven't done the badges yet, but which did you prefer guys? I've made up 6 or 7, and my personal favourite was the Newcastle one or the Spurs. I can't choose between the two, but they were my favourite. So I've decided to do a manager mode guys. It's called Master League, and I decided to do it on Superstar, the hardest difficulty on PES. And I've never played on this difficulty before, so this is going to be something new for me. So we go into the board meeting. Apparently these 3 guys are actually looking to hire a manager. I'm not going to tell you the team just yet, what they come from, but they are looking for a manager. And I thought I could be the right person for them. These guys seem a little bit interested in me. So, you know, I thought, you know what, I'll give them my credentials. I will send an application to sign for this club. So I've given them a name, I've given them a nationality, then it's all about my image. What do I want to look like when I'm on the pitch, what people look at me as. And it took me quite a bit of time. I thought black, white, I'll stick with white as it's just a preference for me. I'm not being racist or anything here. And I thought, you've got, as a manager, you get a lot of new hairstyles. You know, and I thought, oh god, some of these are crazy. You got a big old Fellaini there, some weird Japanese sort of flick styles, what you'd see in all those weird anime cartoony things, and just got some really nice hairstyles. It's what I like about PES. PES go a little crazy with the with their hairstyles. They look really creative. I thought this was my favourite one, so I decided to stick with it. And you know, these guys, they made a choice on who to sign as the manager. And I think we all know who this is going to be. Bam! I'm in my office. I've got a secretary. You know, this is my new secretary, guys. As you can see, it is a woman. We all know what happens when you have women secretaries. They do the work for you. Here we go. I've been signed. Can you see the badge on the back? It's Newcastle United. I thought, I think I can be the man to make their team in general a lot stronger. There we are. We got in the press room, conference room, taking loads of pictures, all that stuff. Just thumbs up, you know, people, so people know I'm here to stay. So back in the office room, you know, the secretary's got some more crap to say to me. Apparently I was a bit nervous, but no, I wasn't nervous in that conference room. Seeing those thumbs up, the smiles, I'm here. Very confident at the job, confident I can do well. We find out that we've got a training match coming up against Dynamo Kiev. So I decide to go on the field to see what the players want, tell them what I want from them. Apparently great sides never compromise when going for wins. That's the spirit I hope to install in all of my players. Hopefully they get it. So here is the team I have currently got to work with. Just to let you guys know, the transfers and not actually, the January transfers are not yet on, and they will not be on this because, you know, it updates the whole game, it doesn't update your saves. So we still have big boy Demba Ba, Tim Krull in there, what can I say, great on this game. Santon on this game is quite highly rated, which I'm not too sure why. He's a youngster, he's got potential, but he should not be that highly rated as he is. Ben Arthur should be a lot higher, in my opinion. We got big boy Kabai, cannot wait to use him. Colacina, he has got a nice rating of 86 on this game. Thoroughly deserves it for being a great defender. I see Vukic, I'm like, oof, great start for the future, Vukic. I like Vukic, me, myself. And then I noticed Sami Amiobe. Pretty low in rating, but you know, it's fine. So I decided, you know, we got to bring in some new players. So I decided to look at the list of targets that these are the players that are more than likely that it's possible I could sign, the highly rated players. I'm looking at them, we've got some big names like Hummels especially. Hummels, man. Why would Borussia Dortmund want to let Hummels go? He's a young star for the future, one of the best defenders in the world, if you ask me. He's mint. We got Jose Callejon, Reus, Blas, blah, 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 blah. And then I see Didier Drogba. I'm like, damn, wow. Samuel Eto'o as well. So I instantly took interest with Samuel Eto'o, Didier Drogba and Hummels. I sent scouts out onto them just cause, to try and get negotiations going, because I really wanted one of them players at least. I myself hate Williamson as a defender. I do not like him at all, so I put him on the transfer market. I decided I'd put Birigi Romano and Sami Amiobi on the loan list, and I thought it was a tough choice on Amiobi. He's getting old, but I decided I'd try and put him on the transfer market, see if I can get any pennies for him until he's done. And I went into my youth squad. I seen this Nuche, I cannot pronounce his name, centre back, 18 years old, 73 rating. I'm like, damn, this guy's looking good. So at the moment we've got four players being signed at the moment, and look at that, man. If we can get any of them, I would be happy. We are going to get the centre back Nuche, because he is a free agent in our youth squad. So the secretary's just letting us know I need to sort out the team, staff appointments, all this sort of stuff, and then check out the sponsorship deals, because we get quite a bit of money for our sponsorship deals. We do have quite a bit of money to spend. We have 80 million if we want to spend it, but we will go bankrupt if we just go boom, 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 because we have to pay for our staff in January. It's either January or September, I'm not too sure. But as you can see there, we have about 33 million to actually spend. Here are the contracts. So if I don't win 10, if I win less than 10 home games during the season, that contract will cancel. This one doesn't have a cancellation clause, which I am happy about. And then the final one, if I win less than 5 home matches during the season, that one will cancel. We don't want to get these cancelled, because these are what give us money. And then I find Arsenal have actually put Chamberlain on the loan list. So I thought, damn, if I can get Chamberlain, I'll be quite happy with that. So we actually got Nuche, or whatever his name was. He is in our squad now, and we go into our first game, the training game against Dynamo Kiev. I've put all of the youngsters and all the low-rated players on to try and boost them, and I've kept Demba Ba and Papa Cisse up front, because we don't have many strikers. That's what I need to sign for the team, strikers. And if I can get Hummels, then my defence will be solid. I'll be happy with the defence. Then I just want to get strikers, because, you know, I personally would like to sell one of the two strikers. But if I don't have to sell them, I won't. But look at that. We're straight into a game, and you can tell we're on superstar. As soon as I actually moved out, bang, tackle. I've never played in it before, like I said, guys. So this is something new to me. I'm not very good at tackling on PES. And look, this just shows how bad I am at tackling. Just look at this. But oh, so lucky he missed that. But then it was a great save there. Great save to keep that out there. But they have a corner. And we'll get already, man. 10 minutes into the game, we are getting very lucky. At the moment, superstar, they've got a lot of pressure on us. But look at that ball. Boom. Trying to get a few 1-2s going. And look at the little flick. Cheeky flick. Trying to get into the box. Cut inside. And then, you know, turn. Boom. That was wide as hell, but hey, it doesn't matter. That was my first shot, and it was pretty bad, but the move was pretty good. Already, again, they're keeping the pressure on. We get lucky again that he can't reach. That's twice now they've not been able to reach. So with 30 minutes into it, they are driving forward. They're breaking me apart like mincemeat, just like anything. A great, great save there by the keeper. To be quite honest, they are all over me, but look at Anita there, what an interception, gets the turn, passes it in, through ball, Papa Cisse, and it was a great save there by their keeper. So that was our best chance of that half, and it's actually quite even this game in terms of possession, 49-51, we've both had 3 shots each, but mine have been more on target. They're lucky they've not been able to reach their ball when it comes to actually getting sliding in for it, so it's a shame on their part. I decide to make 2 substitutions. I take Sami Amiobi off for Marvo, and I decide to bring on Obertam for Vukic, because I wanted a bit more pace and more of an attacking threat up front, so I brought Obertam on. At this point, Dudu is walking through me. Look at that. I did the wrong thing and actually went to attack him. I didn't hold back, and look at that. He just takes me apart, and he scores. So Dudu scores the first goal for Dynamo Kiev, showing that superstar is going to be a tough road for me. because usually I play on the one, the one below this. I can't remember which one it is, but the through ball, Obertan making an instant impact, boom, good save by their goalkeeper again. I should really have gone across goal, but I chose not to. But look at that beautiful ball by Ferguson, and Demba Ba puts it in the back of the net. My first goal on Superstar in my first game. It was a beautiful ball to actually get it through. I was onside. I decided to make an attacking substitution. I decided to take Papacete off, bring Kabay into an attacking midfield, diamond formation, and then put one up front on my own. But look at that. Look at that. It's so hard. But they are so unlucky they've not scored. Straight away, you know, once I get the ball, I have to start passing it. 87th minute, I catch the ball. Counter-attack time. Counter-attack. I run up, Gosling. Boom. Through ball, he's just onside. Look at that. Demba Ba's got it. Demba Ba. Does he score? Does he miss? You'll have to wait and find out to the next episode, guys.